Welcome to Digital Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you gray to binary conversion in this session. So in this session, first I'll explain you the basic steps which is required to have conversion of gray into binary. After that, I'll explain you that gray to binary conversion with functional representation so that one can be able to have connection of circuit as if it is required. And then I'll explain you some examples where we will solve problems to have a translation of gray code into binary code. And at the end, I'll give you some problems in exercise question. So you just write down your answers in comments. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is steps required to have translation of gray code into binary code. So first step, that is to take MSB as it is. So first step, that is to take MSB as it is. Now see, in next step, we need to XOR MSB to next bit of gray code. So in next step, we need to XOR MSB to next bit of gray code. And step 3, that is to repeat step 2 till we find binary conversion. So these are the steps which we need to follow to have a translation of gray code into binary code. So here, let us solve this as a functional representation. So if I say I have a gray code over here, so 4 bit gray code that I have G0, G1, G2 and G3. And this is what we are a little bit to transfer into binary. So first step, that is to take MSB as it is. So see, I'm taking MSB as it is. So here G3 is equals to B3, that I can say. Right. Now here XOR this MSB to next bit of gray code. That is what we need to do. So now we need to XOR this with next bit of gray code. So we need to XOR B3 with G2 and we have B2, right? So let me write that as function. So see, this B2, that is B3 XOR G2. And if you see, B3 is equals to G3, so I can say G3 XOR G2. Now we need to repeat this till we get final answer. So this B2, now that will get XOR with G1 and we will be having B1, right? So we can say this B1, that is B2 XOR with G1. Now if you see B2, so that is G3 XOR with G2. So G3 XOR with G2, that is B2, you can see. And this XOR with G1, that is B1. And we need to repeat this till we get final conversion. So now B1 XOR with G0, that is B0, right? So we can say this B0, that is B1 XOR with G0 and B1 is G3 XOR G2 XOR G1, and this XOR G0, that is B0. So that is how we can have functional representation of gray to binary conversion. Now I'll explain you some examples so that will give you clear idea like how to solve this type of problems. So here we have been given with one gray code. So first I need to write given code over here. So I'm writing 1 and 1. This is what gray code which we have. Now first step, that is to take MSB as it is. So 0 over here. Now this 0 XORing with this 1, so that is resulting into next bit. So 0 1 XOR is 1, then 1 and this XOR with 1 that is resulting into next bit, that is 0. So 1 XOR 0. Now this 0 XOR with this next bit, that is 0 XORing is 0. Now this 0 XOR with this 1, so 0 XOR will be 1. This 1 XOR with this bit, so 10 XORing is 1. This 1 XOR with this 1, so 11 XORing is 0. And 0 XOR with 1, so 01 XORing is 1. So that is how now we can have, this is binary from given gray code. Let me give you one more problem so that will resolve your questions in your mind. So here I'm writing one more. So here we have been given with gray code. So let me write that first. And now we need to convert this into binary. So the basic steps are, take first bit as it is. So this is 1. Now this 1 that will get XOR with this bit. So that is 10 XORing is 1. Now this 1 that will get XOR with this 1. So that will make it to 0 over here. This 0 XOR with this 1 that will make it to 1 over here. This 1 XOR with this 0. So that will make it to 1 over here. This 1 XOR with this 1, so that will make it to 0 over here. This 0 XOR with this 1, that will make it to 1 over here. This 1 XOR with this 0, so that will make it to 1 over here. So now you can see, this is my binary code. So see, all we need to do is, we need to take MSB as it is, and then we need to take XORing of that bit with next bit of that gray code, and resultant is next binary bit, right? And that binary bit with next bit of gray code XORing will be next binary bit. See, that is how we need to repeat this process, right? Now I'll give you some problems in self-study. You write your answers in comments, and definitely I'll get back to you if any query is there. So here I'm writing some questions in homework. You write your answers in comment. So some homework questions that I'm writing over here, and convert that into octal. So first we need to convert this gray code into binary, and after we need to convert that into octal. That is what the case which we need to focus about. So I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will resolve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.